use a vertical shift to graph one period of the function. So we have y is equal to a sine bx plus or minus c minus c plus d. So the coefficient of sine is a, so this should be a. If there's no number, then it's 1. So we have a is equal to 1. Then b is the coefficient of x, so if there's no number, again it's 1. So b is equal to 1. And there's no c, so we have c is equal to 0 because there's no parentheses. Then your d is equal to 2. So sometimes this one is written as y is equal to 2 plus sine x. So it will be the same. Now our period is equal to 2 pi over b. Then this will be 2 pi over 1. So the period is equal to 2 pi. The starting point, there's no horizontal shift, but there's a vertical shift. So your starting point should be in 0, 0. But since you move up 2, so it will be 0, 2. Then our first x coordinate, so this will be equal to period over 4. So period is 2 pi over 4, so this will be pi over 2. Then our second x coordinate is equal twice of period over 4, so this will be equal to twice of 2 pi over 4, so this will just be a pi. Our third x coordinate is equal to 3 times of the period over 4. So we have 3 multiplied by 2 pi over 4. So simplify this, it will be 3 pi over 2. Then our fourth x coordinate is equal to 4 times of the period over 4. So this is just equal to the period, which is equal to 2 pi. Now we can graph. So we shape up 2. So I'll make this down. So this is your x axis and this is your y axis. So the starting point is 0, 2. It's not in the origin because we shifted. So actually, this is our new x-axis. This is our new x-axis. This in the 0, 2. So this is our new x-axis. So now our graph, the amplitude is 1. So you go up 1 here. So we have the second x-coordinate will be pi over 2. So this will be pi over 2. This will be pi. And this will be 3 pi over 2. And this will be 2 pi. So now our graph goes up here with this. So this goes up here. Then it goes down here. Then it goes down here, then it goes up here. So this is our cosine function, y is equal to sine x plus 2. So this is our graph.